they can testify on the kind of destruction that Feast of Carat Priestless Bato de la Rosa, sir, can come to them if they violate the rules, sir. So I really will not dare to do that and lie to you.
Yeah, Bishop, just Bishop, because you know, it pains me to cite you in contempt if I need to do that, because you are the regional director of this particular police regional office of this region, and that would be a slap on the PNP kapag ang kanilang boss ay na-cite in contempt ng isang committee hearing because of lying and testifying falsely before the committee.
Yes, sir.
I hate to do that.
Yes, sir.
Please make sure that you don't lie to this committee.
It will be part of the presentation, sir. And even the future diggings is included there, sir.
Okay, thank you.
Mr. Chair.
Meron pa yung future diggings?
Mr. Chair.
It's included in the presentation, sir.
Mr. Chair.
Dali ha. Unahin ko muna si Jason sa nauna nag-kwan.
Salamat po.
Yeah.
I just want to know from the chair whether the digging was in accordance with the law. I'd like to ask, therefore, the chair to ask the PNP whether they secured a digging permit, because the structural integrity of the building, which carried preschool, kindergarten, elementary students, high school students, college students, postgraduate, nanganganib po ang buhay nila doon sa integrity ng gusali, kung ito ay magkakaroon ng konting pag-inog ng mundo. Huwag sabihin siya pa, huwag mulinog taon, asa man po nito ng mga batang gagmay, nawa magit sila ibang kaagan, anang maumbang itabo. Where did they secure a permit from the building official of the city, Mr. Chair?
General Torre.
Sir,
the question is, did you secure a digging permit from the building officials of the city of Davao or any permit from DNR for that matter? Before you do that?
No, sir.
No?
No, sir.
Okay.
Sir.
Thank you for that answer.
Mr. Chair, may I?
So, it's noted by this committee that he did not secure any permit from any pertinent and competent government agency that is regulating the digging operations.
Mr. Chair.
Go ahead, Attorney Fuentes.
Thank you, sir. Sir, considering that he hired civilians, may we know the names of the civilians that he hired for the digging, sir?
So, you should understand that their property was negatively impacted by the digging operations. That's why they are looking for the names of those people responsible in the digging. So, since ikaw ang nag-recruit noon, please give us the name. Submit Mr. to this committee.
Mr. Chair? Okay? Yes, Mr. Chair, we will...
Ilan yon?
I have lost track, maybe around 7 or 6.
7.
Mr. Chair. But we will provide it to you and just consult my...
Please, before this hearing ends, please submit to this committee.
But I would like to state for the record, Your Honor, that everything that they did is under my responsibility. I take responsibility for their actions.
You are the commander. You should assume all responsibility.
Yes, sir.
Very good. Assume all the responsibility. You are the commander.
Mr. Chair.
Yes, Mr. Chair.
Yes. Building official of Davao City.
Good afternoon. Good afternoon, Mr. Chair. May I ask General Torre if during the time of excavation and all of the construction activities done in the basement, was there a professional engineer architect supervising over the work being done?
Thank you. You heard the question, please answer.
Yes, sir. We have structural engineers and...
Sino? A regional engineering
yes, sir.
Service mo?
We have one civil, one architect, and one structural engineer, sir. I'll cover everything in the presentation, sir.
Ano doon sa presentation mo?
Sir,
Meron silang engineer.
That question came about because earlier when General Torre was talking, he said they hired the experts for digging, which were yung mga minero. In my opinion, that's hindi siguro tama. Yung eksperto natin doon is yung minero. In if yung safety, yung like it was mentioned earlier in the rules of court, yung breaking in, Your Honor, humingi kasi ako ng opinion from NBCDO, National Building Code Development Office, yung executive officer nila. I asked if yung breaking in doon will is applicable to the breaking of building or demolition of any part thereof. According to the commissioner, ang sabi niya sa akin is yung breaking in can apply to breaking of a door or a window to access a building. However, yung act of demolition or breaking structural parts of a building is a regulated activity and it should need a permit or order from the court na will order the perhaps the building official to give assistance to our whoever is undertaking the job. That's all, Mr. Chair. Thank you.
Noted. Sino yun? Sino yung tinanong mo?
Si Attorney Belderol, sir.
Sino siya?
National Building Code Development Office. I think he is the executive director or is okay. Currently, sir. Thank you.
Thank you.
Mr. Chair.
Well noted.
Mr. Chair, in connection with this, considering that I am the chairman of the board of the Jose Maria College Foundation Incorporated, if ever there is going to be any structural damage to the building of JMC, is the police willing to pay for the damages due to the digging that they caused?
I presume they have to pay kung mayroong court order ordering them to pay whatever damages that they have done. Am I correct, General Torre?
Yes, sir. Definitely, sir.
Mr. Chair.
Bayaran nila. Kung you file the corresponding case and pag the decision na korte, bayaran natin sa PNP.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
Mr. Chair. A few days ago, General Torre was in a press con and he very clearly stated that there was no digging. He denied that he nag-dig ang PNP and he said that excavation didn't exist and he also said that those were just Photoshop pictures.
Okay. But that statement was not given before this committee.
Yes.
Before you.
Yes, Mr. Chair.
Okay. Before the public.
He said it in a press con. So, Mr. Chair, this again is the problem that he maybe can tell the truth to you, but once you leave...
Being cited in contempt.
Yes.
Because I am serious in my job. I don't care kung sino man. Basta if you testify falsely before this committee, I have to cite you in contempt.
Yes, Mr. Chair, but unfortunately, not all of us are senators and the Filipino people are not senators and he blatantly lied to the Filipino people about it.
Will you please respond, General Torre? Why did you lie before the Filipino people that you did not do such digging?
Sir, masyado tayong nasa sidetrack. Hindi ko maintindihan, sir, ang sinasabi ni Dr. Badoy.
Hindi,
kung kailang ginawa, sir, I did not do that.
Napakasimple lang.
I did not do that, sir.
Hindi ka?
I did not do that and I did not say that.
If you can
present to me the video, maybe I can review it. But right now, there's no video presented except for the statement of Dr. Badoy who is delaying the presentation of Attorney Torreon.
Okay. Can you please give me that video?
We had the press con 2 days ago and he even challenged Attorney Torreon to prove it.
Ang sabi kasi niya sa press con, he has to... that's the allegation of Attorney Torreon and he should prove it in court and he should prove it walang in court he should prove it because madali nasa Photoshop naman yan, parang Photoshop na yan. Yun po sabi niya.
Sige, last response before we proceed para
sometimes I'm really thinking that they don't want to proceed with their presentation, but I think that sidetracks the issue. Because as to the moment, sir, Dr. Badoy is making an allegation, sir.
This committee,
yes, sir,
does not believe that it hijacks the issue.
Okay,
that,
sir.
That issue is very important and very relevant in this investigation.
So the answer, sir, is no. I did not say things that that Dr. Badoy is attributing to me.
Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you. Later on, Dr. Badoy, you...
We're retrieving the press con, Mr. Chair, where he blatantly and clearly stated that there was no excavation and that it was, those were just Photoshop photos.
Okay. Noted. Kung meron kayong recordings on, eh, palabas natin.
Mr.
Please continue.
One last question regarding sa excavation. Bakit po minadali nila tinabunan kaagad para hindi po nyo makita ng committee po ninyo? Nadali po yun, sir. Overnight po, sir. Napakabilis po natabunan kaagad. Kung sabi niya, accountable siya dun sa paghuhukay.
Okay. Let's be frank about it. Bakit niyo tinabunan kaagad?
Sir, that will be covered by my presentation, sir. Even before, without even the second hearing, we will cover it, sir.
Wait for your presentation.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Thank you. Continue.
So, after that, Your Honor, though we have strong reservations to the legal opinion of our respected government officers, Your Honor, and I am really concerned with the legal opinions that they expressed, no, knowing that they represent the Department of Justice. But anyway, we will continue, Your Honor. At 9 p.m. again, Your Honor, we already covered that. This is on August 29. Unidentified men again were entering, and some had very long haircuts, no? And one was with beard and escorted by the PNP to the compound. But that's covered already. So let's go to August 30, Honor, at 9 a.m., no? The police, through PRO 11 Logistics Office, once again attempted to cart away. They wanted to get the KOJC fire truck, no? Good that lawyer was present there, and they would have been able to seize the fire truck, Your Honor. And the respondents here placed their own battery in order to sneak away the fire truck. Yeah. And at 9 a.m. to 10 a.m. on August 30, there were two PNP choppers, and General Torre was clearly on board because he was shown, Your Honor, some cameras had strong power to capture who, even if they are meters away. And I think General Torre admitted that he was on board the chopper, no? And but the problem is that it hovered too low, and we had reasons to believe that it was purposive, Your Honor, because of the solar panel installed at the top of the building. We had reasons to believe that they were thinking that the solar panels were supplying electricity to the imaginary bunker that they have made the public believe is existing, but despite 14 days, they have not been able to locate. What actually transpired is that our solar panels, Your Honor.
Excuse me. General Torre, did you intentionally instruct the pilot of the chopper to go low so that in order to destroy that solar panels?
No, sir. For that, sir, we deeply apologize, and we are willing to pay the KOJC regarding the solar panel if we really cause that the destruction of that panel.
Thank you.
Because that will be a very dangerous maneuver, yeah, for us. Because
kayo ang pasahero diyan, delikado pag,
yes, sir,
pag lumipad yung solar panel, tumama doon sa helicopter ninyo.
Of course, sir.
Sabog kayo.
Yes, sir. Obviously.
Please continue. So the word of General Torre would bind the PNP that they will pay, Your Honor.
Yes, yes, they will pay.
Thank you, Your Honor. So proceeding from that, Your Honor, this also, Your Honor, is very concerning because one alleged policeman, Your Honor, was dressed as a policeman using police uniform, but it turned out to be a former member of the KOJC who testified during the Senate investigation, Your Honor. And his name is Edward Masayon, but he was made to wear as if his last name was Esclito. And this is really concerning, Your Honor, because the police is allowing certain members, former members, disgruntled members who testified even against the accused as one of their alleged policemen. May we ask General Torre about this, Your Honor?
You answer the question.
What is their issue, sir?
Ang former member ng KOJC na pinasuot niyo ng uniforme at pinapasok doon sa loob.
Are they admitting, sir, that Edward Masayon is a former member of the KOJC?
Huh?
Are they admitting that Edward Masayon is a former member of the KOJC?
It's written there, sir.
Oh, yeah.
So, they admit that bolsters our allegation that we have credible informants regarding the presence of Pastor Apollo Quiboloy.
So meaning, yung si Masayon ang source of information mo?
One of the many.
One. Kailan ito tiniwalag ito from QJC? Kailan ito?